So imagine someone, let's imagine him to be a man, who has no sexual desire to have sex with Arabs, for example. And I'm going to use Arabs in my example because I'm Arab, so I have positionality, so I want to get hate mail. So imagine someone, let's call him John, and John just does not feel that he is attracted to Arabs. Whenever he sees another person, say John is gay also, whenever John sees a guy that might look Arab, you know, semi-curly hair, somewhat of a hooked nose, you know, kind of facial hair, hairy body, etc., etc., John is just turned off. And if John knows for sure that the guy that he met is actually Arab, John just doesn't feel the sexual desire at all for that kind of person. So this raises the question: is there anything morally problematic with John's sexual desires? Is John a racist of sorts? So the thought experiment might proceed something like this, and I'm going to keep it as simple as possible. Suppose someday a genie comes to John, and the genie says to John, John, if you'd like, tomorrow, you can wake up tomorrow, and you will have sexual desires, you can feel sexual desires for all members of all ethnic groups, basically. Sorry, not for all members, because we never sexually desire all members of any group. But you will have sexual desires for members of all ethnic groups, so that your sexual issues, so your lack of sexual desire for Arabs will be obliterated, right? You will sexually desire them much like you sexually desire any other ethnic group, but on one condition. And so John says to the genie, what is the condition? And the genie says, the condition is that when you do sexually desire members of the Arab people, you desire them not from vicious motives. You will desire them just like you would desire members of any other group, basically. And so this is the thought experiment. And what I'm trying to say with the thought experiment is that if John has no problems with the genie's offer, including the condition that the genie has stipulated, this will tell us something interesting about whether John is a racist person or not. And if Genie refuses the offer, this tells us something also very interesting about whether John is racist or not. And so part of this thought experiment is to basically make the point that whether someone's sexual preferences for members or lack thereof of a certain group is not a straightforward story about whether that person, does not tell us, give us a straightforward story about whether that person is racist or not. A lot more factors have to be put into the picture before we can come to that kind of conclusion.